Hello and welcome. Let's take a first look at HDevelop and its basic functionalities. In the description below, you will find an example program. For a hands-on learning experience, download and open the program now. Let's start by running the program. Press the Run button on the toolbar or F5 on your keyboard. As you can see, an image has been loaded. It is displayed in the graphics window. You can adjust the visualization of the image in several ways. For example, you can change the size of the window, restore the aspect ratio, move the image, and zoom in and out with a mouse wheel. The source code of the program is located in the program window. We won't go into further detail about the operators. After watching this video, you should be able to find out for yourself exactly how the program works. The green arrow, or program counter, tells us that the program has been executed only partially so far. Let's reset it and take a look at the whole program. You can reset the program by clicking on the Reset Program Execution button or by pressing F2 on your keyboard. Then go through your program step by step by clicking the Step Over button or by pressing F6 repeatedly. Alternatively, you can click Run or F5 to execute the program until it is stopped explicitly, for example, by the operator Stop. Depending on the mouse position, you can reset the program counter, or you can insert a breakpoint. Note how the program execution now continues at min gray and stops at the breakpoint. All these actions can also be accessed in the toolbar under Execute. Furthermore, you can deactivate and activate single lines of your program very quickly. Simply select the line and click the respective buttons on the toolbar, or use F3 and F4. Now, let's execute the program until the end by clicking Run 2 more times. The variable window displays all variables. They are divided into iconic variables, which contain images, regions, and contours, and control variables, which contain all numbers and strings. You can quickly display iconic variables in the graphics window by double-clicking on them in the variable window. Alternatively, you can right-click on them and choose Display or Clear Display. Display overlays the new object on top of the existing display in the graphics window, whereas Clear Display clears the graphics window first. Finally, we want to take a look at the operator window. Here you can search for operators and adjust their parameters. Let's take a closer look at the operator threshold. Double-click on it. In the operator window, you can see a short description of the operator. You also see an overview of the parameters. In this case, we process the image and store the result in a region. The thresholds are defined by min gray and max gray. The parameters are categorized into iconic and control parameters, and these small symbols tell you whether it's an input or an output parameter. If you need more information about an operator, simply click on Help or press F1 on your keyboard. Now you can take a closer look at the operators used in this program to understand exactly how it works. Additionally, you are now able to navigate through the various programs that are accessible via the example browser. This concludes our video. Thank you for watching.